بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أهلا وسهلا إلى الدرس الثاني عشر. Welcome to lesson 12. In this lesson there are three concepts. The first concept is basically a continuation of the verbs and how to conjugate them, which we already did. ولله الحمد. So inshallah we'll skip that. We'll go to concept number two. المفعول به. So we've seen many sentences in the past, and we saw words that are mansub, and we knew that it was not a mafulun bihi, but we couldn't explain exactly why it was taking a fatha or it was mansub. But inshallah, in this lesson we'll learn a little bit more about what was taking place. So there's something called al-maf'ulu bihi, al-maf'ulu fihi, sorry, fihi, al-maf'ulu fihi fayaha. So maf'ulu fihi is basically you can look at this word as being fi plus the damir hi, fihi, in it. Al-maf'ulu fihi, meaning the action is taking place in it. In it. And we'll explain a little bit further about the tasmiyah, why it's called that. So it's defined as a ismun mansubun yadullu ala zaman wuqu' al-fi'l aw makani. It's an ism that is mansub, and it indicates the time of an action, the time when the action took place, or sometimes the place where it took place. Majority of times we'll see that it's talking about the time. The time. So for instance, in English we would say, I went to school, I went to the university. But if we add a word such as, I went to the university yesterday, I go to the madrasa every day, I go to school in the afternoon, okay? That extra word in the morning, in the afternoon, that's telling us about the time when the action took place. So similarly, in Arabic, we tell the time of the action by using the maf'ulun fihi. And here are some examples. The author says it's Sheikh Abdul Rahim mentions that it's similar to the adverb, and it is very similar to the adverb. So it denotes the time of the action or its place. Amthilatun, examples. Hadartu al-yawma li ziyaratikum. I attended today li ziyaratikum, to visit you all, or for your visit, for visiting of you all. I attended today, al-yawma, and focus on the word al-yawma. Okay, I attended today, li-ziyaratikum. Al-yawma is basically the maf'ulun fihi. It's telling you, when did this action take place? When did the attendance take place? Mata hadarta, when did I attend, or mata hadartu? Hadartu al-yawma, today I attended. So many of times you'll find that the maf'ulun fihi, it answers the question of mata, when did you do the action? Hadartu al-yawma li ziyaratikum, is telling you about the reason, right? Dhahabtu ila suqi sabahan. Dhahabtu ila suqi sabahan. I went to the marketplace sabahan, in the morning. In the morning, sabahan. Okay? Sabahan would be the maf'ulun fihi. The maf'ulun fihi. So notice it's mansub, right? Ismun mansub. And it's indicating the time of the action. Here it's not telling you about the place. Alright, it's just telling you about the time. When? Today. When? This morning or in the morning. Thalatha. Raja'atu min al-jami'ati masa'an. Raja'atu min al-jami'ati masa'an. I returned from the university. Mata? When? Masa'an. Masa'an is the maf'ulun fihi. Okay? Adhabu ila al-madrasati kulla yawmin. Adrasu ila al-madrasati kulla yawmin. I go to the madrasa when? When? Kulla yawmin. Every day. Kulla yawmin. So even though you wanna say that both of them are the maf'ulun fihi, in reality it's always the mudaf. Remember, as I told you before, the mudaf carries all the weight. and i'rab,
the mudaf ilayhi doesn't really carry much, right? So the word is actually kulla. Kulla is the maf'ulan fihi. But even though if we say kulla, it doesn't completely say give you indicate the time. It's kulla yawmin, every day. Every day, right? But kulla is officially the maf'ulun fihi. Okay? But when do I go to the madrasa? Kulla yawmin, every day, kulla yawmin. Okay? And we'll explain later on that there's a relationship between these two words, right? And that's why kulla is considered to be the maf'ulun fihi. The author doesn't want, rahimahullah ta'ala, may Allah's mercy be upon him, he doesn't want, and wa hafidahu, may Allah protect him, he doesn't want to give all of the information about the maf'ulun fihi because it's going to be presented later on in greater details. Sa'adhhabu ila ta'ifi yawm al-khamisi. Sa'adhhabu ila ta'ifi yawm al-khamisi. I will go to ta'if yawm al-khamisi, on the day of khamis, okay, which is Thursday. So which one will be the maf'ulun fihi? It will be yawm al-khamisi. Obviously we know yawm al-khamis is, you know, both the words are together, the day of Thursday. Aina tadhhabu hadha al-masa? Aina tadhhabu hadha al-masa? Where are you going this evening? Where are you going this evening? Nasitu alamat al-istifham. Aina tadhhabu hadha al-masa? So what is the mafulun fihi here? So we're tempted to say al-masa, right? Al-masa. However, in this case, hadha will be the mafulun fihi. Remember the badal and the mubdal min? So hadha is the mafulun fihi. And al-masa is just taking it because hadha is falling as a mafulun fihi, okay? Hadha al-masa. Where did you go? This evening. When? When am I asking you? Is it yesterday, yesterday? No, it's this evening. Then we have a few Quranic examples. One example is in Allah's statement. He says, وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدَى مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدَى وَمَا تَدْرِي. This verb دَرَى يَدْرِي, which we learned, which means to know. وَمَا تَدْرِي, the ma is ma and nafia, is negating this verb. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ. And there's a few details there which you would not know as yet. But just learn that the ma is negating tadri, which we're going to learn soon. You can use ma to negate fi'l mudari. So you're negating tadri. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ. Nafsun is a soul, a nafs. No soul knows. No soul knows. مَاذَا, that which or what? تَكْسِبُ غَدًا. What the soul is going to كَسَبَ يَكْسِبُ, which means to earn. Which the soul is going to earn. غَدًا, tomorrow. Okay? No soul knows what it will earn tomorrow, or غَدًا. So the مَفُولٌ فِيهِ would be غَدًا. غَدًا. That's one example. Another statement, another example is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where he says, وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبَعًا شِدَادًا. وَبَنَيْنَا, بَنَى يَبْنِي, to build. And we have built, فَوْقَكُمْ, above you all. فَوْقَ, above you all. سَبَعًا شِدَادًا, seven. We have built upon you seven. شِدَادًا, seven very strong. Seven very strong what? Well, we know that this is referring to the seven heavens or the seven skies that is above us. سَبَعًا شِدَادًا. شِدَاد meaning strong, right? Okay, so where's the dharf in this ayah? وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ. Where did we build it? Okay, where did we build it in this place? Are we asking when did we build it here? We're saying where. Where? So here comes an example of where it's telling you about the place. The place of where the action took place. وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ. And we have built فَوْقَكُمْ. فَوْقَ is the مَفْعُولٌ فِيهِ. فَوْقَ. Which also is a, if you remember, you remember this is a ظَرْف. This is a ظَرْف. And that is correct, it is a ظَرْف. Alright, do we see any other
الظروف. You might have seen others, right? اليوم. Okay, we will have seen others. So فوق is a ظرف. What you would learn, inshallah, is that many of the مفعول فيه happen to be a ظرف at the same time. There are many sentences where you would find the إعراب will not say the مفعول فيه, it may just say ظرف, ظرف مكان or ظرف زمان, but it's also the مفعول فيه. So sometimes the names are interchangeable. It may be called the مفعول فيه or it may be called the ظرف. We'll go into details later on, inshallah. But the last thing I want to cover is, why is it called fihi? What is so particular about the word fihi? Fihi, because, am I told you fihi is fi plus the domir, ha, right? Fihi in it. It's as though these words, right, is telling you in what time did this action take place? Hadartu. في اليوم, I attended in the day, in this day, right? لزيارتكم. Okay. ذهبت إلى السوق في الصباح, in the morning, right? So it's as though في is kind of understood. The action is taking place inside of a specific time. في هذا الوقت. رجعت من الجامعة مساء, يعني في المساء. In the afternoon or evening. أذهب إلى المدرسة كل يوم. It's as though you're saying في كل يوم, in every day. في كل يوم. أذهب إلى الطائف يوم الخميس. It's as though you're saying في اليوم الخميس. And if you said that, it would have been correct. You said سأذهب إلى الطائف في اليوم الخميس or في يوم الخميس, it would be correct. أين تذهب هذا المساء؟ أين تذهب في هذا المساء؟ Okay. And here we can say, you know, the action is taking place. وبنينا فوقكم سبعا شدادا. Telling you about in which place did we build the seven heavens? فوقكم. All right. So it gives the meaning of في, which is الظرفية. And inshallah, we'll cover more of this topic later on, inshallah.